That's really exciting. And the differences between a text message and a voice message, like in that respect, and obviously it's going to weigh more than that. So, you know, if there's 12 people, which I think there might be.
14. I mean, 14. Without us, 12.
Do you want to take part?
Yeah.
Who knows what it is? I just have to stay available.
What I was going to do is it'd be easier if the groups got the same number, but we can divide that up.
So let's do two groups of six then.
Or three groups of four. Three groups of four.
Yeah.
So what I'd like to give to three groups of four.
Do the buttons to do that?
Yeah, okay. Definitely. So we'll get the buttons.
All these funny buttons.
Buttons, right. In your groups of four, I want you to devise a set of instructions via text message and voice call which another group of four will then receive. Now, we're not going to be using the phones. I want you to... So a text message is a note written on a little piece of paper. And a voice message is you going up to somebody and whispering in their ear. You can set sort of like... So you can think about the time, the place and the person, like in terms of receiving a message. You can think, obviously there's a difference with a text message, which the note kind of captures as well, that I can receive it and then I can read it later at my leisure. Like, so you control if you send it, you don't control whether the person reads it. With a voice call, that demands that they are pay attention in that moment. And obviously, like, some instructions may trigger. What's more interesting is, like, is the actions then that those instructions trigger. And those might be between people, they might just be for that person. So, and I don't really want to give you any more sort of like specificity than that. Other than it's going to be something that will take place in this room.
Can you just say that last thing that you said, that it's more interesting for the actions that are triggered?
Yeah, it's what, I mean, ultimately this is about making an experience happen through a set of instructions.
Yeah.
And like, it's what that experience is. And you might talk about, first of all, in your group, about your one way of coming at this is like, what do you want to make happen? And then like, what's an interesting thing? And then how do we make that happen? And you've got about half an hour to do that, and then that should be enough time to look at and talk about it.
Any kind of message?
Any kind of message.
It needs to be a shorter time. It can't be half an hour and do the sharing, because that's a bit too close.
Okay. 20 minutes. Let's. I'll check in 15 minutes and see how you do.
Yeah.
And then maybe 15, 20.
Cool.
there was a moment where we got the instruction to work out how to win, and that's where I thought it was if we all cooperated. So it was
Yeah, I think in retrospect that would be the part that I clung on to out of the game. The fact that you ended up all deciding to work together, I think that's a hell of a lot more interesting than you were.
Yeah, I think that was most enjoyable live to watch it.
And for us who were observing, like, what was only, like, what was kind of favourite moments in any one thing?
When you were trying to balance
the drumstick on a mic.
Sebastian with the tripod.
Maybe there's another question actually about, so what points did it become clear in any way and sort of what might be happening?
When they were supposed to do.
I guess it would have been quite enjoyable, like, also, what's the opposite, constructing?
Deconstructing
other people's work, you know, so if you're doing vertical and stealing from it, that was sort of fantasy.
I guess these have been made, not necessarily with the audience in mind, but there's also something about the fact that people getting messages in this way, it isn't necessarily fun or interesting to watch, like, because it's not made for that. Everything is inward concern, and which is also actually the case of small town. It's not much fun to watch it, but good to be here. Can we clear the space? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And next group. So you were observing.
Let's sit in this
or
I should have bought something. I feel bad. I feel really bad.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Thank God.
Yeah.
It's like, do I know where you got to?
Messages and interrupting with conversations, and you kind of
like the concept as well about Chinese whispers, that you would hear something and that maybe would send you down the wrong path if you hear it, heard it incorrectly, that you might look something in the wrong place. And thinking of when people hear things, sometimes they're hearing what they think they heard, but it's maybe not necessarily what someone said. And that's just communication in general, I think. So kind of like playing with that concept.
Mm-hmm. One example we had for a way of finding that gem or treasure in another person is the instruction, find someone in the game who reminds you of somebody from your past and give them this note. So we were talking about ways of getting people to connect.
Yeah, and every person having a different note that prompts them to have interaction with someone else.
We were trying to use these as like the treasure, almost as like decoys. So you'd get one of these in the beginning, but you'd actually find the one you were really meant to have at the end.
And these would be both symbols of the immaterial things, so like the memory or the fact about someone or a compliment you pay someone, and also, of course, the physical as well.
Yes, I think we had these two ideas of something, a physical gem, but really it's about the gem in people. But we just didn't quite simplify it enough to get it ready in time for you guys to play.
And it's really useful, I mean, in as much as this is like a first leg of a development process to make something, and certainly with Canon's work, trying to play test stuff as quickly as possible is always really useful because you will always be surprised by what happens. There will always be things you didn't think about, whether it's like where the players are going to be starting upstairs or downstairs, or whether it's like, or maybe why don't they talk to the people who are also in the room? And like really simple sets of like interacting instructions, rules, like in the form, can yield like emergent, like quite complex like behaviours. And it's really hard to predict like what's going to happen. The best way is just like is to play it somehow and you start to get some sense and then to learn from that and repeat. But also sometimes like you devise something which you can't test in that way, at least not immediately. And to be able to pitch it and talk through the experience. Particularly when you were just having no problems, you were ready for this. But the best way, the best single tip pitching anything is if you can talk, if you anchor it around the journey that an audience will make through the experience. And like you get to, almost like second person, like you do, you know, you get your phone ring to answer it and hear this, because that then gives us something concrete to hang it off, and then we understand everything else that we might need to know. So like another question we might ask within what we're going to do. That's the best tip I can give anything for any kind of pitching. But yeah, that's a really useful way to conjure an experience in people's minds that we can then talk about. And similarly, but the development process is always iterative, it's always repeating. We've not used technology really, like you guys, which is beautiful. I think the important thing is that the technology is not the thing. Like with this, certainly this kind of work, it's like what happens, what triggers to happen. And that, yeah, very simple stuff can, very different kind of qualities of message. It was really nice seeing the difference between the notes or the notes when you were kind of finding the notes versus that way it was. Just a bit, you know, people can always read years, a very different thing to watch and I imagine to experience as well. But being aware of like what technology and the qualities of the experience that technology offers is going to be crucial. I've run out of time.
Big, massive thank you to the guests. Woo! Yeah.